Holley say their Sniper 2 EFI system will tune your engine by itself. This sounded too good to be true, so in this video we're going to find out if it can, plus all the pros and cons of the system. Converting from carb to EFI can be scary because you'll traditionally need to source and install lots of parts for the conversion. Next, you'll need to wire up an ECU, and lastly, you'll need to tune, which means you've got to be tech-savvy with laptops and comms cables, and also understand how to tune. Naturally, you can learn all these things, and we do offer courses on these topics. But we also know that you might not want to think about any of that, and instead, maybe you just want a plug-and-play solution, which is where the Holley Sniper 2 comes in. Holley has created a solution that integrates injectors, most sensors, and even the ECU into a carburettor lookalike that bolts on in place of the traditional four-barrel carb. This dramatically simplifies your EFI conversion, particularly since you don't need to source an intake manifold to suit multi-point injection, and it's the perfect product for our 1966 C10 featuring the ever-popular small-block 350 Chevy V8. Holley have understood the pain points with an EFI conversion and done their best to address these as simply as possible. For example, the unit comes with a complete wiring harness that in its most basic form only requires 6 wires to be connected. They also offer an installation method utilizing their PDM or power distribution module, which is great for keeping your wiring neat and central to one location, with the exception of a battery positive and negative, as well as a switched ignition source to power up the module. This is the method we've chosen to go with. However, it's important to note that this isn't critical to the conversion and it's just an added bonus. Holley claimed that by answering a few basic questions on the hand controller, the Sniper 2 calibration wizard will build a base map that should get your engine up and running right away. The real claim to fame, however, is that it will self-tune the fuel table as you drive. No laptop or tuning knowledge required. This all sounded great in theory, but given our experience with self-tuning claims that haven't quite stacked up in reality, we were a little skeptical. But in the interest of science, we were also keen to put Holley's claims to the test. Before we go further, we have to address the limitations of the Sniper 2. Holley have gone with throttle body injection to keep everything simple and affordable. This method sees the injectors located within the throttle body, which would not be our preference if ultimate control was the aim. This is because injecting at the throttle body is more likely to result in cylinder-to-cylinder fueling variations compared to injecting at the intake port like we would with a multi-point EFI system. It's also not possible to time the injector opening and closing to the intake valve operation, and it's impossible to make individual cylinder fuel trims. Lastly, throttle body injection can result in sluggish, transient response to quick throttle inputs. The upshot of this is that the idle quality, fuel economy, and emissions are likely going to be a little worse than with a multi-point EFI system. The Sniper 2 is also missing out on some of the more advanced motorsport functions like traction control and closed-loop gear shift control. But if you're considering a product like this, then it's probably not going to be a deal breaker for you. So does any of this matter? Well, if you're wanting the most out of a highly strung, high compression, high revving NA engine, or you want to make 3,500 horsepower at the wheels with a pair of turbos, I'd say yes. As engine power levels climb, the tuning window becomes narrower, and it's possible that a cylinder running a little lean could end up suffering some damage. However, I guess that 80% of people just want to add EFI to their low strung engine, like our C10. And for this application, it's a perfectly workable solution. So far, we've only talked about fueling, and of course, there's spark, more specifically, ignition timing to consider. This is where the Sniper gives you a couple of options. At its simplest, you can just leave the existing distributor to take care of spark, just like it did with the carb. This, of course, means that short of swinging the distributor to advance or retard the entire ignition curve, you don't get any timing control. If you do want complete control of the ignition timing, though, you can add the optional HyperSpark electronic distributor. This allows timing to be optimized at each RPM and load point, which can potentially produce more power than the ignition curve offered by a mechanical distributor. Not to mention, the original distributor on some of these engines is probably well past its use-by date, and hence not offering optimal spark energy anyway. Let's cover what's actually involved in the install. The installation of the Sniper itself is no more difficult than removing the existing carburetor and bolting on the Sniper in its place. It'll even take a conventional air filter for a stealth look. The fuel system is probably the most involved part, since EFI requires a much higher fuel pressure than a carburetor, typically at 3 to 4 bar. Fuel lines, a fuel pump, regulator, and a fuel filter are part of a separate kit offered by Holley to complement the Sniper 2, meaning you'll have everything you need. It's worth mentioning, however, that you'd want to add a surge tank to your fuel system, as the baffling in a stock tank won't be enough to prevent fuel surge in an EFI system. There is also an oxygen sensor to fit into the exhaust, and this is key to the self-tune functionality. This reports back to the ECU on the actual air-fuel ratio in the exhaust, which the ECU can then compare to the target and make fueling changes as required. Traditionally, this requires a boss to be welded into your exhaust. However, for those not blessed with a MIG welder, Holley supply a clamp-on solution that simply requires a hole to be drilled into your exhaust pipe. Another tick for simplicity. From here, we just need to plug the sensor into the pre-terminated harness and it's ready to go. The entire install took us no more than a few hours and we were ready to prime the fuel system and check for leaks. We did choose to install the optional HyperSpark and PDM, which added a little more time and cost, but as stated, this isn't essential for basic install. The next task is to answer some basic questions in the calibration wizard, such as number of cylinders, engine capacity, camshaft aggressiveness, ignition type, and whether or not the engine is equipped with any power adders. From here, a base fuel table and an ignition table if you've added a HyperSpark is generated. Theoretically, we should be able to start the engine and it should idle quite happily. In our experience, the first start with a standalone ECU often requires the throttle to be nursed to keep the engine alive while we make wholesale changes to get the fueling in the ballpark. In this case, to our pleasant surprise, the engine fired up and settled into a stable idle. Admittedly, the air fuel ratio was a little rich, but this is the point the self-tune function will step in and correct any errors between the desired air fuel ratio and the measured air fuel ratio. And this was the next part we were really keen to see working. Self-tuning is nothing new, and most ECUs have offered this for a while. However, what we usually find is that auto-tuning is a case of garbage in, garbage out. What I mean is that for the best results, we want to be mindful of how we operate the engine. This includes driving in the middle of a fuel cell so that the ECU isn't interpolating between surrounding cells while making corrections. Avoiding sharp throttle inputs that can result in acceleration enrichment can also affect the process. That being said, we bolted the C10 to our mainline dyno and put it through its paces. Firstly, doing some steady state tuning, followed by some wide open throttle ramp runs. The results were actually pleasantly surprising, with the Sniper cleaning up any fueling errors pretty quickly, and after not a lot of time, the engine was running great. Ramp runs were a slightly different story, however. Since the engine passes through the individual fuel cells so quickly, it took a lot of ramp runs to get the excessively rich base fueling at high RPM leaned out to where it should be. This could have been sped up by a little more time spent steady state tuning under higher RPM and throttle, but we voted against this to limit the stress on the engine. So how did the Sniper work out after enough self-tuning? Actually, it was pretty impressive. Holley were up against it from the start since the existing carb actually provided one of the best fueling curves we've seen from a carb, and generally, it drove nicely. Despite this, the Sniper provided consistent and fast starting hot or cold, whereas hot restart had been a real problem with the carb. Drivability was great with improved transient response, and we even managed to pick up a modest amount of power too. We've only covered the basic installation in this video, since that's the main focus of this product. However, for those who are more tech savvy and want to tune via a laptop, a separate tuning cable unlocks all of the Holley's functionality, allowing the ECU to be tuned much like any standalone ECU. Our ultimate verdict is the Sniper stacks up better than we'd expected. It does exactly what it says on the label and offers an improvement in drivability, power, and fuel economy over the existing carb. Is it the right solution for every application? Absolutely not. But if you're looking for a simple solution to an EFI conversion for your four-barrel carb, the Sniper 2 is definitely worth considering. It's still not going to compete with a more sophisticated multi-point EFI system with advanced motorsport-specific functions. But if you're in the market for a product like this, chances are those features won't be important to you. The Sniper 2 is also going to be significantly cheaper, quicker, and less work to get you on the road. Best of all, provided you've got a little patience and some basic mechanical knowledge, you can complete the install in your home garage with a minimum amount of tools. At its simplest, the Sniper 2 is designed to do all the heavy lifting for you. But as your knowledge and confidence grow, you still have the option of plugging in a laptop, getting familiar with the tuning software, and unlocking more control over your engine. If you're interested in learning a little more, you'll find a full tuning worked example featuring the Sniper 2 in our practical standalone tuning course.
If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.